Hey everybody, I decided to go ahead and do this video covering the poll that I put up a couple days ago. And the answers were kind of interesting, a lot of explanations, a lot of discussion. And again, this is actually something that I took from some other trainers I know who put this up and some other coaches chimed in, and some extremely well-known nutritionist even chimed in on his thread. And of course, I had guessed pretty much what I expected for this one. And then of course the good nutritionists who've worked with weight loss people pretty much had the same answer. So the question was, if we put 20 obese people who had previously failed to lose weight on diets, and that was kind of the key, who believed in surveys, again, so they were surveyed to get all this information, that they suffered from slow metabolism and the inability to lose weight even when on a diet. All of them over 200 pounds, I put it at 91 kg in body weight. You put them in rooms where they could not leave for a month. Consensual as an experiment with zero exercise equipment, but unlimited food. Okay, the unlimited food, I think, is what got a lot of people. They were like, oh, well, they would gain weight. So some of the people who put the gain weight, that 17%, it was because of the unlimited food. But people don't seem to realize that's not actually true. And even with lack of exercise, boredom, stuff like that, yeah, unlimited food does not mean that you can gain weight. However, the foods were only very lean protein sources in the form of protein shakes, whey, soy, pea, casein, alternatives, or whatever they wanted. Extremely lean meats, fat under 10% of total calories, fat-free Greek yogurt, etc., were from fibrous vegetables such as broccoli, spinach, asparagus, lettuce, peppers. Food would be cooked in a manner by chefs to make it palatable, but without adding any extra sugar or fat calories. And that is the key. With unlimited food and minimal ability to exercise, what would happen to the majority of them? More than 50%. Okay. All right. The answer is actually the fourth one. Almost over 50% of these people, that's why I said the majority, because there would probably be a few who didn't. They would lose 2.5 pounds or 1 kilogram or more per week of body fat every single week. Okay. And here's the reason I'm giving that answer. And I'm actually glad that at least 30% got that. But the 46%, they're still right. They would lose some body fat and body weight. Okay, so that is still a correct answer any way you break it down. All right, a human being at that sort of body weight would not be able to create even maintenance calories on those foods. I did have one person point out the fat-free Greek yogurt. If they gorged on that and tried to avoid the vegetables, he said, well, they might gain weight. No, they couldn't gain. They won't gain weight. Can't happen with these foods. It's just not going to happen because it's too high of protein, right? The protein percentage is way too high, so even the limited carbs in that would nearly zero, and they would be eating like zero fat if they gorged on that. They wouldn't be able to gain any weight. It would be biologically impossible. All right. I don't know, people are already like, what? But they might be able to maintain if they really, really gorged on the Greek yogurt. So he did have a point there. So setting that aside, if we assume people are not gorging specifically on the plain fat for your yogurt, right? And they're eating more of the other stuff. Again, protein shakes, very lean meats, lots of fibrous vegetables. Okay, so just again, spinach, broccoli, lettuce, peppers. So why do I say that? All right, what people are forgetting, again, over 200 pounds has a pretty decently high energy turnover, even if you don't have a thyroid. So people who are over 200 pounds do not have slow metabolisms. And we need to be clear there. It doesn't really happen. That's a fake thing. And so when people bring that up, this has been studied with meta-analysis. The overweight people do not have slower metabolisms than normal people. Okay, and even a thyroid malfunction is going to be a very minor. It's going to be less change in your metabolic rate than 50 pounds of body weight would be adding, way less. So just your body weight moving, breathing, all those things, you're going to have a high metabolic rate. So when it comes to the actual calories, here's what I mean. All right, when we talk about calories in, calories out, it's not, hey, I have a certain calories and my maintenance is those calories no matter what I eat. The food you eat affects thermic effect, TEF output. What we usually find in the protein overfeeding studies, when people are forced to gorge on protein, even if they have access to other foods, if they are made to hit a minimum protein number every single day, including with shakes, in the studies that have looked at this, they all lost a little bit of body fat. Now, not quite to the extremes that I'm describing here, because they still have access to other foods and fatty foods and, you know, even potentially pizza or whatever, okay? The appetite suppression and the thermic effect and nutrient partitioning of ultra high protein intake diets, you know, so we're talking with 200 pound people, we're talking, you know, 350 grams or more, right? But if they tried to gorge, they would be exceeding that. We always see fat loss. Keep in mind, protein never stores as body fat in humans. Carbs really can't to a significant degree, and we've restricted their access to fat. Their fat intake, if you look at this, is literally like the fat intakes on like the Ornish diet, which medically is considered a more extreme diet, but you know, can reverse diabetes, potentially atherosclerosis, things like that, okay? Purely because, you know, no fat in your diet, nearly zero fat other than just the trace amounts you need to survive, those things don't happen. All right. And they're actually potentially reversed. And I know that shocks people if you say that. No, if you're less than 10% of your calories is from fat every day, you can't really become a diabetic. It's not going to happen. Very, very, very unlikely, even if you're consuming tons of refined sugars. Now, the refined sugars may be an extreme enough case, but it would have to be really extreme. So without dietary fat, these things don't happen. But essentially, when you look at the thermic effect, and then you look at the upper threshold of the gut to absorb stuff by adding the extra vegetables and fiber, all the protein and limit absorptions of everything, some of these people might even be hitting the upper threshold of their gut volume. So they might reach a point where if they tried to eat more, they might start vomiting. Right? People don't think about that. Think about the volumes of these foods versus the satiety. So here's what I mean. There's hundreds, we've seen just by massively increasing protein intake, potentially an output of 600 to 800 more calories a day burned purely by doing that. This has been seen in certain studies. So when we're forced something like this, keep in mind this diet, no matter what food you pick, unless it's the Greek yogurt was brought up, your diet is probably going to be 80 to 90% protein. All right. When you think on the thermic effect, so someone says, okay, what if I eat 5 pounds of chicken and 3 pounds of vegetables every day? That's a lot of food. And that is gorging. You would lose weight quickly. You would lose weight really fast if you did that. So I'm assuming by gorging, they're eating more. You know, what are we talking? 7-8 pounds of chicken a day? Trying to? I mean, any of you ever tried to eat more than 5 pounds of lean meat per day? You ever tried to drink 1,000 calories of protein shakes in a day? Yeah. This would actually resolve it. The problem is that this is not something people would implement or subject themselves to in person, which is why this has to be a controlled experiment. And people say, well, why don't we just prescribe this for people who need to lose large amounts of weight? Well, they're not going to follow it. They're not going to follow it. That's why it's unsuccessful. It's too unpalatable. People would feel too full. They get bored of eating. And then they would drop out of it. But yeah, it would absolutely work. We know this works, and a few people have done it, and they do it, and it works. You know, the people who have done things like this to lose 200 pounds of body weight. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys and gals next time.